Here we go, how to make a scale mail dice bag, part one. So to start off, we're obviously going to gather our supplies and start to weave our scales together. The shape that you're going to go for is a large rectangle, and you want even edges on all four sides. Once you've built the scale mail part, we're going to add some 4-in-1 chainmail to the bottom, and a straightforward way to do this is to add rings to the bottom edge, just like if you were stabilizing that bottom edge. From here, you can either build some 4-in-1 directly off of those rings, or what I prefer to do, which is to force the connecting rings into being oriented in the horizontal direction by attaching an already built 4-in-1 to these rings. So to do this, we're going to lay out a 4-in-1 chain alongside the bottom row and connect them just as you would if you were connecting two 4-in-1 chains together, which I've covered previously. The only difference is that you're going to need to force the rings from laying flat into facing the same direction as the rings on the 4-in-1 chain that you're connecting. Doing it this way is going to bind up your weave somewhat, which is normally something that's undesirable, but it's actually going to work in our favor later. So once you've attached your chainmail, this is what we have so far. Part 2 of how to make a scale mail bag. So this is where we left off on part 1, a rectangle of scale mail with some 4-in-1 attached to the bottom. So start by connecting the chainmail segment so that it forms a complete circle. And to do that, take an open ring and feed it through in the same direction as the other rings. Here's a closer look of what that'll look like with a colored ring. So your connecting rings should match the orientation of the other rings in your pattern. Now we're going to zip up and merge the two edges of the bag. So start from the bottom and work your way to the top, alternating connecting the scales. So at this point we now have a kind of tube, but we need to close up the bottom. In my opinion, the easiest way to do this is to use cord to pull the bottom rings together. Feed your cord through all of the bottom rings. And then pulling the string is going to pull all the rings together and close up the bag. Tie a knot, cut your string, and this is what it'll look like. If you have a large enough ring, using a large ring instead of a cord is a really great option as well. And at this point, we're almost done. Part 3 of how to make a scale mail bag. This is the last section, and we're going to cover how to finish the tops. This is where we left off in part 2. We have a mostly finished bag at this point. I use a cord to cinch up the top. This is suede cord that I personally like to use, but you really can use anything. And I like to add rings to the top scales and then feed the cord through those. I find it easiest to add the rings around the cord at the same time, so I'm just going to run a cord around the whole top of the bag. I also like to have the look of a doubled up ring, so I'm going to go ahead and add a second interlocking ring to each of my attachment points like this. And normally I'm an advocate for finishing or stabilizing all of your edges, however with these I actually like to leave them unfinished so that you can open up the bag further. And as a cincher to keep the bag closed, currently I'm liking using these wood beads. You can use anything or just leave the cord without anything. If you'd like, you can add decorative details to the cord or just leave it as is. And we are done! Now note, since these are made of metal, I do recommend placing items that could get scratched up into smaller bags or fitting a liner to